sending the news this hour. You've heard of Bigfoot and the Loch Ness Monster. Now haiku residents are warned to be on guard after locals spotted what appeared to be a man wearing nothing but treacle and flour. Local law enforcement officials warn, if you see this man, do not approach him. It is thought that he may be a windsurfer.
This is one thing that I was going to wait a while before we talked about. Maybe we'll talk about it now so you can think about it. Because we all have to make some kind of plans for ourselves. It's a free concert from now on. You have to remember tonight, when you go back up to the woods to go to sleep, or if you stay here, is that the man next to you is your brother. And you damn well better treat each other that way, because if you don't, then we blow the whole thing, but we've got it right there.
'96 was a year of change for the PWA, but even despite new management, a new direction, and Bjorn Dungerbeck losing a world title, you can still expect. Anders Bringdell in second place. Scott Benton to poke his tongue out. The Baker Boys will have plenty of toys. And expect Robbie Nash to be as good a sportsman as he ever was. How about the Pritchards, Matt and Kevin? Expect them to be together. And from Hedgie, expect the unexpected. Josh Stone will certainly always be in front of the camera. Oh, Brian Talma will be Irie.
Yeah, man. Cool, man. Hey.
And finally, expect Bjorn Dungerbeck to definitely win overall. So with Dungerbeck's incredible winning streak continuing, what do the other sailors think they can do about it?
Beat him with a stick and take his knees out and all that? Yeah, that would actually work, but I'm not that kind of person.
Well, I've got some Sicilian friends that I've been talking to, but I don't think that'd be a very good idea.
Somebody has to teach him how to lose again, man. We gotta give him losing lessons.
But they needn't have worried. Dunkerbeck nailed himself snowboarding, and the season would start without him.
Now wait a minute.
Hammering local Mistral winds made Almanar an ideal location to begin the 1996 PWA season. And without Dungerbeck, who had won here every year except one, the door was now open for a new face to take the event title.
I'm gonna go get it. have to do now is wait to arrival of Bjorn in Aruba, see how good I really am.
The orange drifts with the wind.
Hello, children. Today, Uncle Robert has some letters. He's going to spell for us some of his favorite words.
KitchenAid.
Oh, Robbie, you are a card. Spell us a proper word. W-A-N-K-E-R.
Wanker.
Oh, Robbie, stop it. Try spelling your favorite event instead.
I don't know. I just can't think of it.
B-E-R-C.
Bercy.
Two events counted towards the 1996 PWA Indoor Championships, with the first being held in true rock and roll fashion at Paris's famous Bercy Stadium.
You know, I've come close before with Eric and with Manolo and with Robert and with Nick. It's kind of nice after, I don't know if it's 6 or 7 years, one or the other, to get one. It was nice.
Wing, ting, wing. Yeah!
For the final indoor of the year, a bigger pool, more powerful fans, and races with rolling starts, just like outdoors.
was really good. I'm really happy. I was running after this since Trindo, and I'm really, really happy. I have nothing else to say.
I'm pretty happy, so also because first time I have my future wife with me and she pushed me all the time, so I'm quite motivated. Thanks. Thank you.
This is my little punk brother, Jason. Yeah, he thinks he's a badass, but I'm gonna show him up right now with the Jaws Challenge.
Warm water and winds that never cease make Aruba a dream destination. But for the gathered racers, the blue skies carried an ominous threat of thunder. Brindell grabbed the early event lead, but Dunkerbeck was never far behind. After a quick burst of tuning, the 8 times world champion re-entered the water and screamed off into the distance. Dunkerbeck's injury was forgotten, and it was business as usual at the front of the fleet.
Lunchtime, I thought, I've got to get away from work. It was just getting to me, and I went to the beach and could see what was going on at the beach and went to the surf, and that sort of clicked and went back to work and sort of said, I've had enough, and they were all surprised, and I left.
Good to come back in the way I came back here. I mean, when the wind was good and strong, I had no problems.
in the light slalom race when it was really gusty. Had a few small problems, but I'm very happy about my results, and especially because it's been such a long break for me.
Boats that can take on the Atlantic and boats that look more like ironing boards.
That's it. You're the winner.
That was a bubble?
Yeah, that was a bubble, yeah.
Oh my God.
This race is so windy, it's incredible. I've never, ever seen wind like this, ever.
Compared to anywhere else in the world, it's pretty windy.
Radical, heavy sailing.
Early July saw the World Tour head to Gran Canaria. With wave performance and racing and winds blasting way over 50 knots, Pozzo provided a route start to the month-long Canaries leg of the PWA World Tour.
Experience like Robbie Nash and Bjorn, they just use the wave. There's not even waves sometimes, and they're still ripping it up, you know.
There was a couple of nice set waves. I tried driving those and ride those, the bigger sets, and I was lucky to have a couple of those, and I'm sure that helped the result. And the jumps, as high as possible and as clean as possible, and I managed to do that. Tomorrow is the slalom for sure. Seems like getting a little lighter than yesterday. Maybe gets even lighter tomorrow, but it's going to be a very interesting, a lot of fun in that slalom, that's for sure.
But the wind didn't die. It just continued to hammer. It was more like motocross than slalom. And many racers were forced to use wave kit as their slalom sails just didn't go that small.
I mean, Bjorn's the fastest guy out there, you know, so I knew he's gonna be trying everything to get past me, so I just put the hammer down and I straightened out everything and just sat there and just held for all the strength I had in the world, you know. And it was close, I know that, but I could feel him the whole way down. I could feel him breathing down my neck, so I was stoked, so.
After the nuclear winds and rocks of Pozo, it was a welcome relief to hit the sand of Tenerife, but perhaps too relaxing, as the wind firmly refused to blow. So what do you do with the sailors? Simple, really. Give them a camera and send them sightseeing.
Here we are in Las Americas, the vibrant heart of Tenerife. And Jason and I have been going around, checking the place out, seen some pretty cool things, and we've...
There's three things I've got. One is the nightlife.
I believe it's the factor here.
Secondly, during the day, of course, is the beach.
And there's something that the nightlife and the beach both have in common.
One is?
Chicks.
Heaps.
Heaps and heaps, boys.
They're English. They're all English.
Now, I hear there's some Germans here, too.
A few Germans.
And some Spanish. Options are endless. They're just endless. Ooh. There's one option now.
Finally, the wind did return, but only enough for a little horse racing.
Standing there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking bastards.
For the final event of the Canary's Leg, it was over to Sotaventu, a real windy location that turned on the juice to provide more challenging slalom action.
me and Kev were sitting around talking before we came over here, and we said, boy, it'd be really nice to do a top three finish at one of the events, and this was it. Oh, I'm the happiest guy on earth right now.
We got a little bit of time before the next race, so hopefully I can put something new together to try to do it better. But right now, I just have to say that I'm proud to be where I am right now. I mean, I've been doing great. You know, he's doing it quite a bit better than me, but that's life, that happens.
Yeah, man, you know how it is. Sometimes the fellas take a life a little too serious, man. You gotta relax and cool your head. That's why we got a little cocktail we're gonna do today. A simple thing, we're gonna call it a relaxer, because that's what we're gonna do today, relax. But yeah, for a nice cocktail, you need some nice oranges. Just gotta go out in the garden and pick them. Well, you know, I know some of y'all around the world may not have oranges in the tree. Just go to your local grocery and buy one. All right, yeah, man, the next thing we gotta do get is some passion. This is a passion fruit vine. Got your orange? Cut them up so. On top, squeeze them. When you cut the passion fruit, they cut them so. Excuse me, my fingernails are a little greasy because, you know, I was fixing my car. So a little grease doesn't help. It lets things go smoothly down. Now here, major ingredient. When you pour it in, now it depends what kind of drink. You want a powerful one. This is called a relaxer. Or you want a conversational one, where you want to have more conversation going, you put two. Yeah, man, so we come over into the blender. Powerful, man. The relaxer, man. One, a relaxing. Two, Malibu's, if you want to conversate.
A serious rascal.
Let me tell you, you had a night AI tree, animal, but you want to moderate Iron Man.
It's kind of exciting going down the course at like 39 knots on the last 2 inches of your board, just skittering, like just on the verge of a disaster the whole time. And then this jumpy comes and no spin out, please.
Just along the beach from the racing site, the famed Soto Ventus Speed Course once again provided a flat stick drag strip for the PWA Speed Finals. Just in case you've ever wondered what it's like to blast down a speed course, we fitted up Pete with a head cam for a rider's eye view.
Here we go! Look at that speed! Get on the front of this little wave! Bloody hell, big gust from behind! Whoa! Blow it off! Trying to get on the front of this wave here! Really fast run! Back it up! So try and get to the bottom of the dump! A bit close to the beach, only about an inch of water there! Try and keep the thing tired if I can! Get it a bit flatter now! I'm going to really try and tire it over these bumps! Get close to the beach, where it's a bit flatter! Well, it mustn't spin out now! Sometimes you lose the wind at the end, but it's got quite a good gust! Really go for it now, the end's inside! There we go! Check the speed! Sixth position, 36 and a half, not bad! Woo! Come to a stop!
Word got out pretty quick about the head cam. Sure enough, everyone wanted to play, but some weren't so lucky. Dave White held onto the boom so tight with excitement, it broke. Jared Scully came to town for the New Zealand speed record. Went home with the long jump record. Let's check that from the beach. Crazy Frenchman Antoine Elbow wasn't quite sure whether to go up, down, or sideways. Let's have a look at that one from the beach. There he goes. Better keep practicing the swimming, Antoine. After the non-stop action of the Canaries, it's always a relief to head off to the Greek islands for some low-key racing and relaxation.
Hello, children. This is Robbie's friend, Anthony. Isn't he a big boy? Can you guess what he's spelling?
That's a G.
But that's a C, Anthony. Oh, my, this is a muddle.
A
no, that's a Q. Oh, what a mess. Shall we ask older brother Nick to help?
The I and the G. Stupid. Honestly, I'm sorry he didn't go to school for long.
Gincho.
Back to the top for a radical off-the-lip maneuver.
Gincho became the only pure wave competition of 96. Even though it wasn't a big event, the conditions went off.
Alcoholic, kind of mood. Lose my clothes, lose my lube. Cruising for a piece of fun. Looking out for number one. Different partner every night. So narcotic, out of sight. What a guess, what a beaut I fall past. And it all breaks down. Roll reversal, got the muse in my head. She's universal, spinning me round. She's coming over me, me. And it all breaks down at the first rehearsal. Got the muse in my head. She's universal, spinning me round. She's coming over me, me. Kind of buzz the last for days. Had some help from insect ways. Comes across all shy and coy. Just another Nancy boy. Woman, man, a modern monkey. Just another happy junkie. 50 pound, press my button, going down. And it all breaks down, the role reversal. Got the muse in my head,
I've never sailed against Bjorn before, and I've never done so many wave heats before in my life. I've looked at some of the footage and I feel like I was getting better towards the end of the week, so hopefully in the future get better results.
Opportunities to finally kick Bjorn's ass.
Brighton is one of the most unique events on the tour, and usually it blows. But this year, it was sunny and flat. Just one race counted. That's all, folks.
Hopefully next year I can get a first or something a bit higher.
Today we are preparing tequila shots.
Okay.
Four tequila.
It must be the same.
Okay, stop! Two slices of lime, cut so. The process is as follows.
Put some salt. You eat the salt.
No.
Then you drink all one shot. And then you put the lemons in your mouth. Yeah.
Lick, shoot. Oh! Suck.
Do you remember the time when you were a girl from Mars? I don't know if you knew that. Oh, would step the playing cards and you were intimate cigars. And she never told me her name. I still love you, the girl from Mars. Sitting in our dreamy days by the water's edge, on a cool summer night, fireflies and stars in the sky, gentle glowing light from your cigarette. The breeze blowing softly on my face reminds me of something else, something that in my memory's been misplaced. Suddenly all comes back, and as I look to the stars, I remember the time. Yeah. by the window. It felt as if you'd returned. I thought that you were standing over me. When I woke, there was no one there.
About this time of day, the boys are getting hungry, so we come back to our place. So I like cooking some eggs. You can use a one-handed approach. You see a bit of egg get stuck in the bottom there. The eggs come from chickens. I like doing all my whisking in this central part of the island. As you can see there, I'm sort of increasing the whisking speed. You can use one left hand, one right hand, but I generally toss with my left hand, so... Okay, eggs are done there, as you can see, they're all nice, light and fluffy. All these now is for the boys to eat them. And that's how to do eggs the Polico way.
The final major event of 1996 went down on Germany's cold North Sea coast in front of massive crowds. Nasty weather for spectators, but what's it like to compete in conditions like this?
Full on miserable, like too windy.
I say these conditions are really, really difficult to sail well in.
Oh, I think it's brilliant. Brilliant conditions. We've been waiting for it all week and now it's slowly turning on today.
I think it's fiery, man. It's kicking butt.
We're gonna have a great day. What do you think, Patrice?
Great day as well.
You ready for it?
Yeah.
Ready to go up to the top again? Woo!
Well, Patrice is getting better and better, isn't it?
It was hard to make the right decision in this. But I'm happy that I got him.
I haven't won a contest for a while, everyone was sort of expecting me to do well, and it's after my knee injury. Oh, it's under, I'm so stoked. That's great.
Oh my God.
Damn good. Well, it's kind of hard to explain, you know, how wave riding really feels. It's a combination of a lot of different things, depending on what a person's used to.
I guess you'd have to call it a bit of a rush, really.
It's like being on drugs.
The sense of satisfaction is pretty tremendous.
That's the best part of winter, for sure.
You know, you're out there with the ocean. You got to be one with it, or else you're not going to be standing up too long, because it'll take you down real quick. Mother Nature's got a lot of power behind her, you know.
In a way, it's all a matter of time. I will not worry for you. You'll be just fine. Take my thoughts with you, and when you look behind, you will surely see a face that you recognize. You're not alone. I'll wait till the end of time. Open your mind. Surely it's plain to see. You're not alone. I'll wait till the end of time for you. Open your mind. Surely there's time to be with me.
Flappy maneuvers are for flappers. I'm gonna smack the lip till I die, and if that ain't gonna cut it, then I'm over it.
It is the distance that makes life a little hard. Two minds that once were close, now so many miles apart. I will not falter though, I'll hold on till you're whole. Safely back where you belong, and see how our lovers grow.
Let's do the song. All right, so stand up and
I can't. I
and perform.
I'm not going to sing that song.
Come on,
no,
sing.
That's too embarrassing.
Come on.
Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. I, yeah.
No, because he'll take the piss out of me for the rest of my life.
You know, everyone's going to do it.
Wild thing, dun, 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 dun. You make my heart sing. Dun, 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 dun.
Can I sing a country song for you? On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with the gambler. We were both too tired to sleep.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
I need someone else here to do it with me, because I'm just far too embarrassed.
I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it.
Out on the patio, we sit. We watch the lioness crack open cane food and laugh and think that This is Australian.
Guantanamera, Guajira, Guantanamera.
It's the fact that everyone's going to hear it.
It's me for first day. It's my.
Right, okay?
Yep.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as if they're here to stay. And I don't know any more from here. So that's me done.
The final event of the year saw the championships already decided, making the event more formality than racing reality.
and I don't give a damn shit.
And 10 times sounds pretty nice, doesn't it? It would definitely be a magic number. That would mean twice as many as Robbie. I'm not planning on stopping racing right now anyways, and I will definitely aim for a first position next year again. I got 4 months to go and just sail in perfect conditions.
I think everybody's gonna take a bit more serious now just because Björn has always gone out and said, I want to win 10 times, right? So that's why everybody has to go, nope. 9 is all right, but 10 is a little bit harder. So we'll see. Maybe he's going to walk us like he's been doing the other years, but we're sure going to try very hard.
Good. All right, good. Cut it there.